Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the split button component to it. The React split button triggers a default action when the primary button is clicked, and provides a list of actions when the split button is clicked. It has built-in support for icons and their positioning, various sizes, disabling items, item separators, displaying the component right to left, and UI customization. In this video, you will learn how to configure the split button component with built-in features. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the split button component, I type the npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-split-buttons-save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the split button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React split buttons package. Then I include the split button component tag here. To add content for the split button, I just add the content property and set its value as paste. Here I want to display four options. For that, first I define the variable named items of type array and assign string values to the text property to display in the menu items. Then I assign this array to the items. Next, I open the app.css file and remove the default styles, then I import the material theme CSS references. To align the component, I define the styles text align and padding here. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. Look here, the split button component is displayed with the content paste and menu items. Paste, paste special, paste as formula, and paste as hyperlink. Notice that the split button items are displayed continuously. If you want to group and separate the options, use the separator property. To display a separator after the first two options, within the items array, I simply add the separator property after the paste special option and set its value to true. See the split button now, the separator is shown after two options. Next, I will show you how to add icons for the split button. To add an icon to the split button, I set the icon CSS property and set the class name as eButtonIcons and ePaste. Within the app.css file, let me define a font face with a specific source path and name its font family button icons to start accessing the required font icons for this split button at the application level. Then, assign the appropriate content value to access the needed paste icon. As you can see, the split button is displayed with the paste icon. Notice that the paste icon is displayed at the left side of the button content. To change the button icon position, use the icon position property. To change the icon position to the top, I define the icon position property and set its value to top. Look at the icon now, it is displayed at the top of the button content. Next, I will show you how to add icon for the pop-up items. To add an icon to the pop-up items, I set the icon CSS property and set appropriate class names to it. Then I open the app CSS file and assign the appropriate content value to access the needed icons. As you can see, the pop-up items are displayed with the icons. Notice that the split button pop-up items are listed vertically. If I want to list them horizontally, I have to add a custom style to the CSS class property of the split button component. Within the app CSS file, I define the class custom pop-up items and add CSS styles, float, font size, padding left, and font style to it. Then I define the CSS class property and assign the defined class to it. To display list items without a separator, remove the separator property from the items. See now, when I click the drop-down arrow, the split button pop-up items are displayed horizontally and without separators. Next, I will show you how to disable an item from the menu. I want to display the paste special option in a disabled state. For that, I add the disabled property in the paste special option and set its value to true. Now, you can see the paste special option is disabled. Finally, I will show you how to disable the split button. To disable the split button, I just add the disabled property and set its value to true. Look, the split button is in a disabled state. In this video, I have shown you how to add the split button component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features, like adding icons, displaying them in different positions, setting different pop-up menu positions, and grouping items with separators. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.